In both World War I and World War II, American Indian soldiers used their own tribal languages to devise and send coded messages that were never deciphered by enemy forces. Their words, literally, became weapons of war spoken in the language of victory.
Represent the Choctaw tribe, World War II combat veteran, Mr. Slick Spilly.
In 1992, a rare gathering of World War II code talkers from three tribes took place during an honor powwow held near Oklahoma City. There, Choctaw, Comanche, and Navajo code talkers shared their wartime experiences and explained how they used their tribal languages to talk the talk that defeated America's enemies.
I knew as I read current events, newspaper accounts, that we were preparing for a conflict, but didn't know where. And I was at the right age, and more or less curiosity led me to go into service. That picture of the platoon that I was in was taken at Fort Sill, September 16, 1940, when I was taken. I was a squad leader. Start out with, we had around 17 Choctaws. Some of them were transferred to headquarters. Some was sent as runners between companies, sending messages. You know, this individual would send messages to the next unit or something. And that's how we survive, is just using our language, because we had it at hand. We didn't go no classrooms and study, because we just talked to one another like we did back home.
There was a man that came around and talked to several of us for the purpose of joining the Army to be code talkers. And we went in around, this is December 40 when he was recruiting us. And then we got sworn in. I got sworn in January 1, 1941. And we went from there to Fort Benning, Georgia, took our training. We started out with 17. And the time we entered the war, there was only 13 of us left. And after basic training, then they started on the different types of communications, how to operate, tear down, and repair, like telephone, radio. A lot of military terms, there's no Comanche word for them. So we had to sit down and figure out a name for each. Just for instance, like guns, we just have one name for a gun, and that's Thawoy. You get in the military, you got all types of guns. You got your artillery, small arms, you got your machine guns, different caliber machine guns, and we had to work out a word for each one of those different types of weapons.
In my younger days, I went to the Fort Sill Indian School at Lawton, and they had, if we talk Indian, they would punish us. But we would get around and talk to each other as an Indian, and when we see them coming, we'll hush up. Not only at Fort Sill, there was other schools. As far as warriors, they always tell me the Comanches were lord of the plains from around Mexico, Oklahoma, Kansas, and on a little bit up to Colorado. And I've heard a lot of good things when they ask us to do what we did. We gladly did, and we probably would do it again if they ask us. You have to talk Comanche fluently, and then the other one listened to it, and he could write it down in English, and that way the Germans could listen all day, and it's never been written.